Sleigh bells ring, choir singing. Wonder what old Santa's bringing. It's a warm and fuzzy time of the year. Snowflakes fall, the temp is dropping. Family's out together shopping. It's a warm and fuzzy time of the year. Elves are working overtime, making all the toys. Reindeer hooves on every roof for good little girls and boys. A big old cup of steamy cider, fall asleep by a cozy fire. It's a warm and fuzzy time of the year. It's a warm and fuzzy time of the year. It's that time again.
Wow, that is so beautiful. That's John McLaughlin right there. John, that is so beautiful.
Wow.
You are so good at what you do, and you've been doing it for a long time. John McLaughlin is in the studio. Ocala has been listening to John McLaughlin for decades. I've been one of those guys that I didn't know John, but I knew Sugar Bear, the band that you were in. So,
yeah.
So good morning, John. How you doing?
Good morning. I'm doing very well. Thank you, Larry.
Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you for contributing to Ocala Covers Christmas, the group we created.
That's been so much fun.
Oh, I'm glad.
It's been a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it.
I'm so reluctant to do anything with the internet, but that one seems to really have hit everybody the right way, you know?
It really has.
So
a lot. I mean, all sorts of people are contributing.
Yeah, yeah.
I've had a lot of fun watching the kids sing. And
yes, you know, when the children
really
sing.
Great. It's casual and just a lot of fun.
That song we just heard is your original song, right?
That song was actually by an artist who recorded it was Billy Gilman.
Oh, okay.
And he did it kind of upbeat.
Uh-huh.
But I don't know why, but that day I felt that way about the song.
That is just pretty, and it just sounds so good. What are you recording on?
My iPhone.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. I know.
That sounded like you were in the room here, and you did bring your guitar, so we will get something,
yes,
right?
Yes.
From the room.
So. I just set my phone down and sang.
That is outstanding.
Memos.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing.
And you've been recording.
It sounds really nice to your system.
And you've been recording for how many years?
Well, my goodness. Before I moved up here from Miami, I moved up here from Miami in 71, 72. Mm-hmm. But I recorded down in Miami even. I've been playing music all my life.
Robin remembers you guys as, because she was, you know, one of those motorcycle chicks that went to the bars.
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You guys are such fun. I loved you guys.
Yeah. And I was crossing paths with you back in those days. We were running into the band. I was telling John before we went on the air, Robin, that I have a memory of being in one of your houses. How many guys are in Sugar Bear?
When we did this album, there was four of us.
How many... Now?
Now there's three.
Okay, because?
Well, the trio just seems to work.
Oh, okay.
It seems to work. We've been together. Ivan, my bass player, and my best friend, we've been together since we were kids.
Who do you do the duet with, the duo that I see sometimes on Facebook?
I do it with Ivan. I also have another duet I do with Tony Mongerio.
Okay.
It's three pieces now, me, Ivan, and our drummer, Rick Cosner. You know Rick?
No, I don't
been
think so.
Been around Ocala forever, born and raised here. He's been with us for 30 years. So.
Is that my. Right?
We're established.
You are.
Oh, no, you're more than established. You're more than established. I think I know you guys better than I know the Royal Guardsmen. I only have met them a couple of times, and that was in the studio here, so... But I ran into you in one of your homes. I remember one of you reading the liner notes to...
I was trying to recall that incident. I don't recall.
Why I would have been there, I don't know. But I must have been, what do you say, 78 you did that?
Around 78, so, I think, something like that. So. I'm just guessing it. We didn't put any dates on the album.
So I would have been 23, something like that.
Just a baby.
Yeah.
you remember this album?
We're all babies.
You know, you and I were on an album together.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh. Yes. That was the one WMOP made.
You remember this?
The Band-Aid album.
Yeah.
Yes.
You wrote a song, and Margaret sang it.
Thank Margaret. Yeah.
Great song.
I still see Jeff, by the way, her former husband. Yeah, yeah.
I don't see either one of them. I don't know where Margaret's at.
I don't know where she went.
We've lost touch.
Margaret Dillon was her married name, or what was her name?
Dennison. Wasn't it Margaret Dennison?
Yes. Margaret
Dennison. Was her maiden name.
Beautiful singer.
Oh, she was fantastic.
She's so good, but you know what happened? It became what would you call it? So honey bear, honey and sugar bear, something like this.
Sugar bear and honey.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was very successful.
That was really good. It was like a different band for a while there.
Yeah, she was so talented.
Yeah,
she played the bass, she played the keyboard, she sang, she was great out front.
Yeah, yeah.
And she was actually a waitress at Mr. G's. That's how we met her.
Is that right?
Oh, my.
We were playing Mr. G's. We were there about 4.5 years.
Mm-hmm.
And Margaret waited tables. Mm-hmm. And somebody says, you ought to hear this girl sing. So we do this all the time. We call people up.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And boy, that worked. Mm-hmm. I mean, we had a very successful combo there.
So we want to get to know you a little bit. You said you came. Where were you born? We'll start there.
I was born in Fort Lauderdale.
Uh huh.
And raised in that part of the country.
And when did you move here?
Moved here in 71 or 72.
So were you an adult at that time?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I was an old fella already.
So what brought you here?
Well, Ivan and I, we had a band down there in Miami, and we were very successful, making good money, playing six nights a week, big city like that. And a friend of ours who used to play trumpet with us, he lived in Gainesville, and he got a gig for us up working in Gainesville.
Mm-hmm.
At the Lamplighter Lounge in Gainesville.
Okay. Oh, yeah, we love that place.
Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a nice place, and rock and roll. We mm-hmm. came up here, and he got us a gig for the summer. So we brought the band and all the kids up and everything, and we rented a great big house in Citra, Florida, 3 stories,
mm-hmm.
and just for a working vacation. Well, we never went back. We fell in love with it up here.
Oh, nice.
Citra at the time was... I don't know if you remember all the orange groves.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Oh, sure, yeah.
Oh, my gosh, it was so gorgeous.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
We just fell in love with it. I owned a home in Miami. Ivan had a house down there. We sold our homes, and we never went back. We raised our families here
in
Marion County.
Nice.
And
how this place has changed since those years. Is,
oh, my gosh.
Is it something you – are you happy with what's changed, or do you wish it could be the way it used
well,
to be?
Well, I kind of like the small-town feel.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Ocala and Marion County, it's a great place to live.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, the surrounding areas, the villages, you know, brings us a lot of work.
So how has your music changed over the years? How has that changed?
Well –
what's the difference between the musician you are now than the musician you were on that album?
Well, much more seasoned, that's for sure.
Like, what do you hear when you listen to old stuff? What do you hear? Like, if you could go back and coach yourself, what would you tell yourself?
Good question. I'll tell you, Larry, I listened to this album, and the arrangements and the musicianship was pretty doggone.
Are you talking about the MOP album?
No, well, this was a great song that we did on this album here. Sing Along. It was a great song.
How many songs do you have on that?
This whole album, there's some good music on there.
Yeah, who's on that album, by the way? Do we know any of those people?
Well, we got Denise Burns.
Okay.
I don't know these folks. The Burbank Band.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know them?
No.
But Larry Whitler. But it's a lot. There's a lot of good music on here, and we had a ball. I think it was a contest, wasn't it? It was a contest.
I think so. Was it Kentucky Fried Chicken or something?
And it had a big Band-Aid on here, yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
It's
a horrible album cover, right?
Yeah. I've got 2 copies left.
Mm-hmm.
And the Sugar Bear album, I've got 2 or 3 of those left.
So tell me about Sugar Bear. You and Ivan started the band?
Actually, Ivan and I had a duo.
Uh-huh.
We came up here with a horn group. We had 5 pieces. And ended up... it kind of split up here and there, and we had a trio. Ivan, his brother, played drums for us, Chalice. Great drummer. And we were working steady, and Chalice kind of went astray. and split. And so it was just me and Ivan, and we were doing a duo. And playing clubs around town and stuff. And H.C. Perriman, you know H.C.?
Gosh, the name rings a bell, but I'm not really sure.
He's an icon around here.
That's H.C. right there? Yeah. I remember that cover. Oh, my gosh. Which one is you?
I'm a handsome guy now. This young feller. But this is Ivan. Trent Slimmer was our drummer.
Uh-huh.
But H.C. came in and heard us one night, and his band had just recently broke up. He was fronting the band Judas. They played out at the bottle clubs a lot.
Oh, yeah, I remember
those
too.
Days.
Yeah,
now, that
I
was some wild times.
Clubs. Yeah, those were great.
Was it Judas or Judas Priest?
Those were great.
Judas. Judas Priest was a...
Wasn't there another band, local
there's
band?
I don't know if they were local or not, but Judas Priest was a big rock and roll headbanger group.
Oh, okay. I thought for some reason they were local.
They made it pretty big. But anyway, he had just broke up with his band, and he asked Ivan if we'd like to get together, and that worked very well.
Mm-hmm.
He was a great front man. H.C. Perriman was the best front man I've ever worked with.
How did you guys get gigs? What did you do to get work?
Get on the phone, call people. Reputation, you know.
The good old-fashioned way, right?
Yeah. You know, knock on doors. H.C. had a lot of contacts.
Wait a minute. You didn't post anything on Facebook?
Oh, no. I didn't know about it then. It's amazing, isn't it? It's amazing.
Well, it is funny how people get gigs now. Is that with Facebook or Instagram or those kind of things?
Yes, it is. Yeah. That we get a lot of work like that, but mainly we do work with a booking agent these days, and it works very well for us.
Is it local? Somebody local?
We don't play local hardly at all anymore. The band is mainly down south, St. Pete, Tampa.
Oh, really?
Within 2 or 3 hour driving range.
So you're on the road a lot.
We'll drive a couple hours. We like to be home at night, so we don't go anywhere.
Oh my gosh! So you commute like 8 hours a day?
Yes,
you're in the car.
We'll drive 3 hours. You know, maybe four.
Yeah,
but the money's real good.
Yeah,
the booking agent does us real well. I mean, we're nice gigs. We might go and do an hour and a half concert.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just we're sit down and we're.
And now you're still Sugar Bear? You still called Sugar Bear?
Still called Sugar Bear.
And you're playing today at ARC?
I'm playing today for ARC. We've been doing that for about 8 or 9 years now.
Oh my gosh. Were you friends with Troy Strouder?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Troy, he's living in St. Augustine now.
I know. And
he'll probably be there tonight.
Oh, good.
It's their Christmas party.
Yeah.
He said the ARC.
They
Christmas
have a sit down Christmas party.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So he and Keith Caton is part of his old band too, Blues Busters, right?
He's got a blues act in that's working over there on the beach.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I see him about once a year. He comes for this party. You know, the kids all love him. The residents all love him. And
and
they'll get Santa Claus.
Oh, that's so wonderful.
Sugar Bear performs, and it's an amazing audience. Mm-hmm. I mean, from the very first note, the dance floor is full.
Oh,
I mean,
wonderful.
It's fantastic. It really
that
is
a beautiful place. Yeah, that's a wonderful thing you're doing for them, too.
Well, and you know what, Larry? The place would be packed at the Hilton.
Mm-hmm.
The room would just be full of people.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
And we have to play Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer 3 or 4 times.
I bet.
Love that song. They love that song. But
so it's just the three of you?
Just the three of us. Yeah. Well, today we'll actually have a friend of ours, Nick Savage. He's a saxophone player from Gainesville. He usually does that with us every year.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah, I love the horns.
Oh, he's fantastic. He's a real showman.
You did a song for the Irish pub, the thing I put the accordion to. What was that for?
That was for the Cup of the Irish is the name of the facility.
Oh, did a song for them. And then I heard it, and I thought, oh, my gosh, wouldn't this sound good with the musette sound of the accordion? And in today's world, I could play along with you and make a little kind of silly recording that was fun to do.
It was a lot of fun, and I love the way it turned out.
I do, too.
That was really neat.
I did, too.
And I haven't been able to save that for some reason. You need to send it to me.
Okay, I'll find it.
That's
somewhere.
A lot of fun. You did a little video thing with it, too.
Did I?
You added some.
Oh, just so you could see. I know why. Yeah. So we could put it on Facebook.
Yeah.
Because you can't put audio on
Facebook.
You can't put audio on Facebook. Right.
I have put stuff on there where I just put the my phone down and pointed a blank wall and saying, you know. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Did you go through a stage?
No, that works.
I'm curious if you went through this stage. And this is, by asking you, I'm kind of telling you that I also did, in case you did or didn't. Where you get sucked into the newest best, the newest thing, whether it's synthetic sounds or massive overdubbing or all those things. I got sucked into them. And then after a while, I realized, you know what? The guitar and the voice is basically what I like.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you go through that?
Through the years, we went through all kind of different stages.
Yeah.
The fads of music, you know, we came up here, we were a rock and roll band, big time. Mm-hmm. Bunch of hippies.
It's just so great, isn't it?
So much. We love the bottle clubs and going to listen to you guys. It was wonderful.
We always were, you know, trying to make a living, and we would change as the music changed. We went through the disco era.
Did you go through the urban cowboy era?
Yeah.
Did you go? Did you surrender to that, or did you stick with what you did?
Well, wait.
Did you guys play at Six Gun Territory ever?
Where?
Six Gun Territory? Have you heard of this place?
We never did play there.
No?
I went there many times.
Well, Robin worked there. That's why I was asking.
I loved it. I loved it. I took my children there. I love that.
Yeah, it was a great place.
It's a shame it folded up.
Mm-hmm. So you brought your guitar, and do you have something to play?
Well, certainly. We're going to bring the guitar. I got to sing, you know.
Yeah.
Sure.
I feel like singing.
So we have only one mic. I'm going to just let you kind of, I'll try to figure out a way to make it make sense.
Will it sound as good as my phone?
I bet not. No, it'll sound good. It'll sound good.
Excuse me. Let me get tuned up a little.
Sure.
I should have done this before I started.
Oh, you tuned it the good old-fashioned way. You don't have an electronic device?
Yes, this has got one built in.
Oh, you do have one?
Oh, this is a great. I love this.
It's built in?
Yes, it is.
Oh, that's. Oh, my God. I thought you were using your ear. Oh, look at that, Robin. He's got one built
in. Wow. It's a Martin.
Have you ever played at the oh, my gosh. What's it called, Robin? The Opry in Weirsdale?
Orange Blossom Opry.
I have never been there.
Oh, they would love you.
Would love you.
That would be great.
That's an amazing audience out there.
I've heard a lot about the place.
Yeah, it's wonderful. It's right in Weirsdale. Oh, that sounds good.
That does sound good. Is that a Martin?
And Robin, you're a fellow mandolinist.
Yes.
Is that the right word, mandolinist?
Yes, I think so.
I play the mandolin. I love the mandolin.
Oh, I bet you're super on it.
I can play some songs on it.
I bet.
What does Martin do? What does Martin do to make their guitar sound so good? So he was asking me, he said to me, "You got some nice instruments, do you?" And I said, I grinched because I like mine, but I don't have a Martin. And
well, this is a Martin, but it's not a high dollar. Martin makes some high dollar guitars.
I know. Do you know where I went? I went to Sound Exchange one time. And you know the guy with the long hair is this?
John?
Yes,
Johnny?
The owner, John.
Yeah.
Says, "Hey, I want you to play this guitar." And I sat down with one of those Martins. And it was like, "Oh my God, this sounds so good." I felt like I was better because it sounded good. And it was $2,000. I said, "Oh, well, never mind."
Yeah. Well, it's true.
Yeah.
It's true. And the older they get, the better they get. But a nice instrument will make you play better for sure.
Mm-hmm. So do you play acoustic when you're with the band, or do you play electric?
Electric.
Oh, okay.
Play a Fender Telecaster. That's my main squeeze.
That's yours, huh?
I love a Telecaster. But how about if I do something fun?
Let me shut up and let you do some music, okay?
This is I get a lot of requests for this song at the assisted living facilities I play at. I always get a chuckle. Dashing through the snow in my rusty Chevrolet. Down the road I go, sliding all the way. I need new piston rings. I need some new snow tires. My car is held together by a piece of chicken wire. Oh, rust and smoke, the heater's broke. The door just blew away. I light a match to see the dash and then begin to pray. The frame is bent, the muffler went, the radio's okay. Oh, what fun it is to drive my rusty Chevrolet. I went to the IGA to get some Christmas cheer. I just passed up my left front tire. It's getting hard to steer. Sliding down the road, right past the county cop. I had to drag my big feet just to get the car to stop. Oh, rust and smoke, the heater's broke, the door just blew away. I light a match to see the dash, and then began to pray. The frame is bent, the muffler went, the radio's okay. Oh, what fun it is to drive my rusty Chevrolet.
Oh, that's marvelous.
That's so good.
Absolutely.
I don't know who wrote that song, but I get a kick out of it.
That is so good. Isn't it just fun to hang out with musicians, Robin? It's just so
it
much
is.
Fun,
it's
right?
such fun.
Yeah.
It's such fun doing that.
Yeah.
You guys get to do that a lot.
Yeah, with each other, we get to do it. Yeah, we play on First Friday. Do you ever do the First Friday thing?
I haven't done it. You do it in the gazebo there? Or?
No. We do it at the corner by the chocolate shop.
Yeah.
Okay.
That old sandwich shop that is closed right now, we use that little fenced-in area.
Uh-huh.
So we're like in the zoo. We're like animals in the zoo.
Yeah.
just playing there. Yeah.
It's a
Robin and the Giant.
Yeah, Robin
and
the Giant.
It.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Well, I'll have to get up there and see you all. I have been down there a couple of times. I visit my buddy Steve Lopez.
Okay, yes.
He's an artist, as you know.
Yeah, he's wonderful.
He's coming in tomorrow?
That's what
yes.
I heard.
Yeah.
He put it on Facebook. In fact, he got me to put mine on Facebook. Because I saw it. He said, great news. I've been invited to do WOCA on Friday. So, of course, I had to go and...
That's how
sure, of course.
Yeah. I think we've invited everybody. If you're on Ocala Covers Christmas and we haven't invited you, please let us know, because I went through it. I don't know if I missed anybody or not, but
yeah.
I'm so enjoying this. And what we're going to do is close the group like after the holidays. So I'll probably keep it up till New Year's, and then a year from now, you'll see what you did last year. You see. In 2019, you just go, oh my gosh, that was a year ago already.
It was a year ago, right? And boy, the years do fly by, don't they?
Yeah. So where should you have next gig today at ARC?
Got a gig at ARC today, which is always a lot of fun. We'll have turkey and dressing and the whole nine mm-hmm. yards, and everybody will have a great time. It's about 2.5 hours long.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday, we're at Ocala Sun RV.
For their
annual Christmas party. We play there every year also.
Did you go through a stage with Sugar Bear where you decided no more rowdy gigs? Did you ever go through the rowdy gig stage?
Oh, my gosh. Did we ever?
Tell me some of those stories.
Name the honky-tonks we played lately.
what kind
the
of
The last one we played was Cactus Jack's in Salt Springs.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever been there?
No, yes. But it sounds...
Yeah, yeah. Robin says yes. Oh, no. Biker chick.
Exactly.
Cactus Jacks. I mean, it's one of the last honky-tonks in Florida. I mean,
what was
still
it like?
Going.
Tell me what it was like.
Well, it's an old wooden building, and you walk in there, and the floor's kind of sad. The dance floor, when you're dancing, you know, you're kind of... The dancers will drift down the incline into the stage, and if you're drunk, you're... But, I'll tell you a funny story. Happened there. True story. We were playing there one night, and I was on my break, and this guy comes walking in through the back door. He had a 4-foot alligator in his hand.
Wow.
I swear to God.
Believe it.
The people were dancing in the jukebox, and he took the gator and threw it out there on the floor, and he scampered between the crowd, and he had to tape his mouth shut.
Okay, that's what I was going to ask.
But the people were, you can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
Screaming. I mean, it was a panic, but true story.
What was the gator mm-hmm. doing?
Was the gator scampering? You know, he was panicked too.
Yeah, he was scared. Yeah, sure.
But that's the kind of folks that go out there. It's one of those places, if you don't have a knife or a gun when mm-hmm. you get there, they'll give you one.
Yeah, for sure.
But it was a fun place, but that was a honky-tonk.
Yeah.
Smoke.
So did you decide not to do those kind of places?
Well, we did. We don't do any bars anymore.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah.
The closest thing we play to a bar nowadays maybe be the Ocala Eagles Club.
Oh, okay.
We play there once in a great while.
There you go.
But we really don't do bars. Mostly gated communities and stuff like that around Florida.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And it's just so much better.
And you still have people dancing on the dance
floor. Oh, my gosh, dancing
like
crazy.
In those gated communities, they love that dancing.
No more 5-hour gigs. You're not playing 5 hours in a mm-hmm. smoky bar.
Yeah.
The band, we're blessed. People still like to hear these old guys.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, my gosh. No, it's just pure music.
So good.
That's what the only thing about age is in our mind, I guess. I don't know. It just sounds beautiful. I love the stuff you do, the way you play, the style, the confidence you have. It's just so, everything's so good.
I always say music is my vitamin.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I believe that. You know, I've always played music since I was a child.
So besides the guitar and mandolin you mentioned, what do you play any other?
I play the cigar box guitar a little bit.
The cigar box? Did you make it yourself?
Built.
You made
mm-hmm.
it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Played with a bottleneck.
How many strings? How many strings on it?
Four.
Really?
Uh-huh. Four. It's kind of an odd tuning, but it works. it works. And you put a lot of distortion on it, you know, and it sounds pretty nasty.
Are you guys recording?
Well, thanks for asking. We just actually recorded a CD of cover tunes, and we got about four originals on there. But basically, it's for promotional. When we travel down south and do concerts.
Really?
Yeah, we give them out and sell them for a real good price, just for promotion. But yeah, we just got out of the studio. We recorded it at Passion Studios. Are you familiar with?
No. I'm so out of touch with that whole scene locally, and well, anywhere really. I don't go to studios at all anymore.
If you need to do some, if you guys think about doing a little recording, which I'm sure you can come up with some nice stuff to do.
They're here in Ocala.
It's local. It's over by the college. He's got a real nice. Wayne Johnson's his name.
Okay.
The studio is Passion Studios. And he's got a beautiful studio in his home, with all the latest equipment. And he's just a real nice guy, easy to work with, and does a great job. But we just did that CD and excited about it.
Do you want to play something else?
Yeah.
Can you play something else?
Can I play something else?
Or would you play something else?
Here's one I bet you remember. You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen. Comet and Cupid and Donder and Blitzen. But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? What's his name?
Rudolph, it should be.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as he shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. You'll go down in history.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
So good.
You remember that song. Yeah, but you are amazing.
Fun. I love fun songs, you know, happy music.
I have one question about the drummer. Does he play a regular drum kit or are they... electronic.
He plays regular.
He does. Oh, I love that.
He's got an electric kit. I think he's still got it. I think he tried it once or twice, and it's just not the same. You know, you get the with the
regular. I think that's where what happened to all of us older musicians is that we went through that. Here's the newest thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And we loved it and wore it to death.
It's so true. I've got at the house. Containers full of pedals and stuff that I bought through the years.
Right.
And you know what? Nothing sounds better than this.
I know.
I finally realized, what's wrong with the sound of the guitar?
Yeah.
How would you want to mess it up?
It is true. It is true. It is true. John, it's such a great thing to have you in the studio and to kind of connect after all these years and to talk about the past. Don't be a stranger. When the album comes out, you guys come on in here and promote it.
For whatever
it's worth, it's just fun and we would love to have you. Thank you for contributing to the Ocala Covers Christmas.
I want to thank you for putting that together.
It was just
I told you several times it's not so casual and fun.
People just
have fun with it. We've all sing Christmas carols.
I know. Right? The only thing I ever deleted from it was a Taco Bell ad. I don't know how that ended up on there, but there was a Taco Bell ad. I said, okay, I like Taco Bell, but I don't want any ads on here. Now you can advertise your album, though. That's a lot different.
Talking about
music. Okay. John McLaughlin, do you want to give us a website or anything so people can look your music up?
Well, you can go to the Facebook page.
Okay.
The Sugar Bear Band Facebook.
Oh, I don't know that I know that one. Let me find it. Well, I didn't know you had a Sugar Bear page.
I think we have some video in there and some pictures and, you know, stories about what we did this week or whatever.
Sugar Bear. All right, let me find it. Is it one word or two words?
I think it's one word. The Sugar Bear Band.
Or sugar
Facebook.
The Sugar Bear Band.
Hold on, I'm fine.
There may be some video in there of people dancing. And we play in the villages a lot, and boy, they dance.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Those people are crazy down there.
Oh, yeah. No, they love it. The villages. We've been down there.
I see it. Okay.
Raining.
Oh, there you guys are.
Dancing with umbrellas.
Right, right. Exactly.
Oh, my gosh. Okay,
gosh,
I'm going to like you.
Stop.
And follow you. There you go.
All right. Good deal.
Now you got a new follower.
Good deal. We need all the help we can get, Larry.
And you guys have
it one day.
You guys have your upcoming gigs.
Have you met Joe Martone, the owner of the station?
Yes, I met him the other. We played. Did he tell you?
No.
I played the bridge. They have a band.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, he was over there.
They were auctioning the reef, and he was there. He was the announcer.
Right. What a voice. Right. Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
And I saw him on the Christmas covers. Ocala covers Christmas. He did a song. What a man!
You got to hear his version of "Mary, Did You Know." Oh my gosh! He did. Here he comes.
What's all the damn noise in here?
We weren't saying anything about. We're not talking about you.
No, not much.
No, Joe.
I know this guy.
John, let me tell you something. Joe's rendition of "Mary, Did You Know" is the absolute best you'll ever hear.
Big head.
Big voice.
You know, two radio guys, and you're not
enjoyed
even near the microphone.
There you go.
Oh, there you go. Okay. Yeah, they're just walking away. All right. Hey, John, thank you.
Still live?
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
We're still live. I thought you were done with the segment.
Well, we went a little bit long. We bumped it. The next guy was somebody named Travolta. We just said, forget it. We'll just let John be on. This John.
Wrong John. I'm sorry. John wanted to come on. Sorry, John.
John McLaughlin, I didn't mean to shake you away. Thank you so much for being on the air with us today. That was fun.
I had a great time.
You got to pick one of the microphones we're talking to. They can hear you a little better, John.
Thank you, Robin.
You think he was? You think he never seen a microphone before?
All right, we'll be right back.